one is a glorious thing. King of kings, thank you for life. This morning I am happy and glad that you are about to be exalted of his word. Let us pray, Father, thank you, not unto us, but unto you, glory and honor be given unto you. Lord, we pray, God, that even as your word is reaching us this moment, open our heart of understanding to lean and learn from the word in Jesus' name. Lord, it will not be to hear I know, but also to do of this word in Jesus' name. Amen. By the grace of God, I am Joshua Satoran. I'm here to share this exhortation of his word with us. As we listen, the Lord bless us in Jesus' name. Amen. This morning, we are going to be looking at a topic titled, Where Are You? Our text is Acts chapter 9, 10 to 22. We will read verse 10. And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias. And he said, behold, I am here, Lord. The topic is, where are you? That is the topic. God called Ananias' name, and he answered, behold, I am here, Lord. What would have happened if Ananias had not been there? What if he had been doing something else and was not listening to God? The Lord might have found somebody else to do his will, but we don't know for sure. We can say this, Ananias would have missed the greatest opportunity of his life. How many people get to lead someone to the Lord who imparts the word like Apostle Paul did? There is great significance in the fact that Ananias was there. He was in the place of communion with the Lord. He was listening and attentive to him. This doesn't come overnight. Certainly, Ananias has spent much time in God's presence. How many days, weeks, or years has Ananias spent seeking the Lord before this time? As far as we know, God hasn't done anything before in his life that was as spectacular as what he was leading him to do at this time. However, Ananias remained faithful. He was there when the big opportunity came. Where are you? We sometimes fail to recognize God in us. When God wants to speak to us, sometimes we are nowhere to be found. When God wants to tell us things, we are gone, we disappear, we are not found. So where are you? That is the question. Is your heart always prepared to receive from the throne of grace? Is your heart always connected to receive from the throne of grace? He speaks every minute. He communicates every hour. But the heart of so many is not there. Depleted, confused, unstable, unsterilized actions. Wickedness runs in the heart of many. And so they can't hear when he speaks, because they have a contradicting heart that is contrary to God's. But God help his children. You know what you're going through. You know what you're passing through. The
It is a contradicting moment in your life. That is it. Let's always be prepared, because we don't know when the Lord will talk, speak to us. We often fail to recognize that we aren't normally going to see angels or have vision during our time of fellowship with the Lord. We won't always have goosebumps running up and down our spines. There is just the gentle peace and assurance of faith that God is with us. The spectacle has come only on occasion, but we must constantly practice waiting on the Lord. We must always be on call for the Lord. Do you think God has ever called you and you weren't there? Don't let that happen today. Make sure your antenna is up and your faith is switched on, so that when the Lord calls your name, you will hear Him. Don't be deaf to it. I pray the Lord bless this word in our hearts, in Jesus' name. I pray the good God Himself will guide our soul more in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Even as your children go about the business of the day, strengthen them. Give them grace. Give them power, vigor, the anointing and the presence to walk absolutely in you in the name of Jesus. Take away pride. Take away any form and any kind of the shackles of darkness from their path in Jesus' name. Amen. By the grace of God, I remember humble self, Joshua Satoane. Don't forget to join me tomorrow for another exhortation like this. Till then, stay blessed and stay safe in Christ Jesus.